What's up, everyone? I'm your host, Asarai, and welcome back to Wild Rift MetaCheck. In this series, we're digging into how League of Legends went off the grid and in the process spawned the entirely new esport, Wild Rift. Since League of Legends transformed into Wild Rift, the ways that you generate gold have changed in a couple subtle ways. All of the jungle camps and minion waves have roughly doubled in gold, making the game progress much more quickly. On top of that, there are some new mechanics as well. Standing near a dying minion in Wild Rift will reward 40% of the gold you would have gotten for last hitting it, much how like assists work in League of Legends PC. If your whole team is near a dying minion, you will all share 40% of that minion's value, so this strategy is optimal for two players in a lane. While this strat acts as a good replacement for support income since there are no support items in Wild Rift, it's not just limited to the dragon lane. Junglers coming into the mid lane to help push a wave means that your team actually gains gold. This encourages junglers to help their laners, incentivizes ganking, and can even act as a method of funneling strong carries for a team. Check out this clip. RNG's jungler comes mid for a quick gank, but mostly to help push the wave. They use this pressure to rotate to the Baron lane for an easy dive onto ThunderTalk Gaming's top laner. To explain more about gold sharing, I have my high ELO co-host, a guy you don't want to run into in the Baron lane, Hell's Devil.
Hey Azurai, you're totally right for once. Gold sharing is indeed very important in the Rift, and a really good example of this is Dacron Gaming. Dacron Gaming used this strategy to make sure their star player Huiba was strong enough in his graves to take down their opponents in the Spark Invitational. So you can see Huiba and YK walking through the lane together instead of YK farming alone while Huiba farms his jungle. Notice how YK doesn't last hit a single minion, only getting the shared gold while Huiba gets all of the last hits. This is a great example of how to generate gold as a tank or support, YK, and funneling the gold to your carries, which is Huiba in this case. Neutral objectives like the Scuttle Crab, Dragons, and Rift Herald are all much more gold efficient than staying in your own jungle. So instead of just taking jungle camps when an objective is up, the jungler can actually run to a lane, share gold with their teammates, and get priority on the objective. When I play jungle in high elo, I always have tons of different strategic options at my disposal depending on how I want to win the game.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks, Hell's Devil, for sharing those nuggets of wisdom. While the gold sharing changes the way players are approaching the Rift, it's not the only difference in strategy we're going to be seeing in Wild Rift esports. Join us next time for more deep dives into Wild Rift strategies and trajectories in the esports world.